Hello friends, in this video you will learn to solve sorting elements of an array by frequency program. The task is, given an array A of integers, sort the array according to frequency of elements. That is, elements that have higher frequency come first. If frequencies of two elements are same, then smaller number comes first. Input output, I will explain the example. Here is the example input. First one is the number of test cases 2. So we take, in every test case we take the two lines. First line is the number of elements, second line is the details of those elements. In the same way remaining test case also. Then output, to get this output, see this, the first test case. By seeing this, 5 occurs 2 times, 4 occurs 2 times, 6 occurs 1 time. Higher frequency is 2. In that, 2 elements are same frequency, 4 and 5. So print the smaller one, 4 first 2 times, then 5 next 2 times, 6 occurrence where frequency is 1. So it is printed last 6. To solve this task, I have written a code. Here is our code. I am using t variable for number of test cases, taking the t value. To execute all test cases, I am using while loop with t minus minus. In that, every test case, we take the n value, nothing but number of elements, and we create an array with the size of n to store that elements. To get the frequencies, I am using map. Its key value is element value. Mapped value is occurrence value. Map variable is m. When I am taking the values, the same time I am pushing the that element values into the map. So, see this. 5 comes, that occurrence value is 1. Once again 5 comes, that occurrence value become 2. 4 comes, that occurrence value is 1. 6 comes, the occurrence value is 1. 4 comes, the occurrence value will become 2. So after this for loop, I am having the details like this. Four 2 times occurs, 5 2 times occurs, 6 1 time occurs. This is the details in the map. Then we need to get the elements by the frequency. There is a chance for same frequency, multiple elements having the same frequency. For that reason I am using multi-map. It can have key values, multiple same key values multi-map can store. That's why I am using multi-map with variable name mm. Then from the map, I took the all values into the multi-map. Key value is occurrence value, frequency of that element, I second, and mapped value is that element, I first. Using for loop, auto I equal to m dot begin, I not equal to m dot n, and I plus plus. Mm, multi-map, insert the I second comma I first. It is now, after ending this for loop, in the multi map the details of this elements is like this: 1 6. Then 2 4 2 5. This is in the multi-map after this for loop. Using stack for printing how many times that occurs. Using stack for if there is same occurrence values, those elements is pushed into the stack to get the right output. So See this. We need to know one more thing. In the multi-map, when the occurrence value is same, those are sorted by mapped values. That's why in the map, in the multi-map, the values is like this: 1, 6, 2, 4, 2, 5. Even 5 comes up first, but it is stored in the last line, 2, 5, like that. So see this. I am starting. It is, we need to print the higher frequency one begin first. For that reason, I am starting traveling from reverse order, from ending to starting. That's the reason. For that, I am using this for loop I equal to mm dot r. R is used for reverse order. R begin, I not equal to mm dot r end. In that, I am using one more temp for occurrence to store the occurrence value frequency. I first is the, by seeing this, I first is the 2. So while loop starts the execution, 2 equal to equal to I first, yes, same. Then I not equal to mm dot r n. To take the that many times, that many frequency of time, I am using C variable to take that frequency and push that elements that many times. That how much of frequency is there, that many times that element is pushed into the stack. While C minus minus, it is 2, 5 is there. So 5 is pushed into the stack 2 times. Then I increment. I know. Then 4 also having frequency 2. So it is in the limit of mm dot rn not equal to, then temp I first also 2, temp also 2. Then C take the 2 value. That 4 also pushed into the stack 2 times. Then I increment. I first is the 1. 1 is not equal to 2. Then it stops the execution. Then this while loop begins start. Stack empty or not? Not empty. In that stack, we having 2 4s, 2 5s. Then it is printed out. Stack top is 4. 4 is printed first. Then stack pop. One more 4 is there. That also printed. Then stack pop. 4 4 printed. Then 5 in the stack. That prints. Then 5 popped out. One more 5 is there. That prints. ST top. ST pop. Then stack is empty now. This while loop stops execution. Now we get the output 4 4 5 5. Then I value temp equal to I first 1. Temp stores the temp value is 1 now. Then 1 equal to I first, yes. 1 equal to 1. Then C take the 1. While loop executes once. In that time, we push the 6 value into the stack. I increment, I is ended. It is reached, that's end. So while loop stops execution. Stack empty or not? Not empty, because it's having 6 value. Then 6 is printed. Stack top, S6 printed. Then stack pop, that element is popped out. Stack is empty now. This while loop stops execution. This also ended. This for loop also ended the execution. So we get the this output 4 4 5 5 6. Then new line for next output. See this, our code is right or not by compile test. Expected output, our output is same. Then submit. Yes, it is correct answer. With the execution time, 0.01. Happy to see you. Thanks for watching.